Are you ready to discover the caffeinated beast lurking in the beverage aisle? Here are the top 5 highest caffeine drinks on the market today. Death Wish Coffee. This coffee brand claims to have the world's strongest coffee with a whopping 828 milligrams of caffeine in a 16-ounce cup and equals 13.8 shots of espresso. Wow! Anyone interested to have almost 14 espresso shots at once? Are you a coffee addict? Do you rely on your cup of coffee to get you through the day? Could you imagine giving up your morning cup and that first hit of caffeine into your head? Well, if you're like most people, you probably don't fully understand how addicted you are to the most consumed psychoactive drug of modern times. How many caffeinated loaded drinks or foods do you consume every day? Are you getting way too much? What are you getting it from? Is your tea innocent? Or your chocolate? Or your chewing gum? Do your symptoms show up out of the blue? Or out of the hidden sources of caffeine making its way into your body? Well, guys, today we are delving into the shaky and shady side of the most consumed psychoactive drug. From its mysterious origins to its dangerous side effects, we're serving it hot brewed, black, and aromatized in this video. Let's enter the world of caffeine, this brain stimulant rich history, widespread usage, and old roots that stretch back thousands of years. That's right, caffeine has been a part of human civilization for longer than you can imagine, way back to its discovery in China around 1000 BC in the form of tea, to its later rediscovery in the ancient kingdoms of Ethiopia around 850 AD. Legend has it that a herder who noticed his goats getting jumpy after eating the berries of an arabica plant, caffeine-rich plant, gave the berries to a local monk who then used them to create the first cup of coffee. The local tribes wouldn't bother to go through this preparation process, though. Instead, they would chew on the leaves of the coffee plant for a quick pick-me-up. The Mayans and Aztecs believed that the coffee plant was a gift from their gods, and they would use it in religious ceremonies. In the 15th century, coffee was introduced to the Arabian Peninsula by traders. It soon became a staple in local culture, and coffee houses sprang up across the region as places for socializing, discussing politics, and, of course, sipping on caffeine-fueled beverages. The craze then spread to Europe, where it caused quite a stir. Some religious leaders banned it, calling it the devil's drink, while others embraced it as a tool for staying awake during long sermons. Regardless of the opinions, it quickly gained popularity among the masses and soon became a staple in households across the continent. Caffeine even played a role in the American Revolution. Legend has it that American soldiers were supplied with caffeinated drinks to help them stay awake and alert during battles. And today, caffeine is a multi-billion dollar industry, with people around the world chugging energy drinks, sipping lattes, and downing pills to get their fix. Caution though, too much caffeine can lead to some seriously jittery consequences. Did you know that caffeine is present in more than just your morning cup of joe? Oh yes, it's hiding in much higher concentrations in items you wouldn't expect to find it. Energy drinks, chocolate bars, decaffeinated coffee. Wait, so it's not decaffeinated? Teas, chewing gums, cakes, coffee, ice creams, and even some over-the-counter medications. It's everywhere, and its usage has skyrocketed in recent years, leaving a trail of dependency, addiction, and even death in its wake. Yes, folks, several deaths have been reported due to caffeine toxicity from caffeine powder supplements in the market. But how much of it is there? How do these products compare to your everyday espresso shot? From boosting brain power to causing jitters and dependence, caffeine is a complex and powerful substance, and it can have a big impact on the body and brain. First off, caffeine works by blocking the neurotransmitter adenosine from doing its job of making you feel tired. This means that when you consume caffeine, you'll feel a burst of energy and alertness as your brain pumps out adrenaline and other stimulating chemicals. But as Paracelsus, the Swiss physician, alchemist, and philosopher put it, the dose makes the poison. Caffeine gets toxic only when it reaches a certain level of consumption, which in our modern world is one of the easiest things to reach. Too much caffeine can cause your heart to race, your hands to shake, your head to ache, and many, many other not so pleasant conditions to experience. Yes, certainly caffeine can improve focus and concentration, making it a popular choice among students and workers looking to get an edge. It's also been shown to boost memory and reaction time, and some research suggests that it may even reduce the risk of developing certain neurological diseases, like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's. But the shocker? Long-term heavy caffeine use can lead to dependence and withdrawal symptoms like headaches, irritability, brain fog, lack of concentration, and if you're a caffeine fiend, you may also find yourself developing a tolerance to the effects of caffeine, which means you'll need more and more to get the same boost. So, are we addicted? Are we consuming way too much? Or better yet, are we being manipulated by subtle and effective tactics? Yes, we are. By restaurants and multi-billion dollar companies that use a variety of tactics to hook us on their caffeinated products and keep us coming back for more. And these tactics are getting better every day, starting from the portion size. Have you ever noticed that the size of your favorite caffeinated drinks just seem to keep getting bigger? It's no accident. Restaurants and companies know that the more caffeine they can get you to consume, the more you'll crave it and keep coming back for more. What about the sneaky addition of caffeine in unexpected places? Have you ever picked up a so-called energy drink only to find out that it's loaded with caffeine? Or maybe you've taken a bite of a seemingly innocent piece of chocolate, only to feel your heart racing a few minutes later. That's because companies are smuggling caffeine into all sorts of products, hoping to hook you on their caffeine-fueled wares. And let's not forget about the marketing tactics. From flashy advertisements, celebrity endorsements, and all sorts of tricks to make caffeine seem cool, hip, and essential to a good time, with buzzwords like energy and power. Other unethical tactics? Of course, companies also use sneaky placement tactics, putting their caffeinated products in high traffic areas or at the checkout counter where you're more likely to see them. And who can resist a free sample? Companies know that once you've had a taste of their product, you'll be more likely to want to buy more in the future. But perhaps the sneakiest trick of all is hiding the fact that their products contain caffeine. Some companies don't list caffeine on the label or use other terms for it, such as natural energy. This makes it difficult for consumers to know exactly how much caffeine they're consuming, which can lead to dangerous overconsumption. Are there caffeine limitations set by the FDA? Yes. In most countries, there are regulations in place to ensure that the amount of caffeine in food and drinks is safe for consumption. For example, in the United States, the FDA has established guidelines of 400 milligrams of caffeine a day for healthy adults as an amount not generally associated with dangerous side effects. It's important to note that the effects of excessive caffeine consumption can vary depending on a person's weight, age, and general health. In general, consuming more than 400 milligrams of caffeine in a single day commonly leads to negative health effects such as jitteriness, rapid heartbeat, high blood pressure, insomnia, dysphoria, seizures, and even heart attack or stroke in severe cases. Yes, some companies and individuals add excessive amounts of caffeine to their products in order to create more of a potent and exciting product. The FDA has also established a guideline of no more than 71 milligrams of caffeine per 12 ounces of a conventional food or drink. However, despite these regulations, there have been instances where products with illegal and excessive levels of caffeine have been found on the market. Which drinks are these? Bang Energy Drink. This energy drink packs a punch with a whopping 300 milligrams of caffeine per can, which equals 5 quick shots of espresso at once. Still high. Nitro Gold Brew Coffee. This canned coffee packs a caffeine punch with a staggering 305 milligrams of caffeine in a 16-ounce can, or 5 shots of espresso all at once. Black Label Energy Drink. With 270 milligrams of caffeine per can, this energy drink is sure to give you a jolt the same way 4.5 espresso shots would do. Reign Total Body Fuel. This energy drink contains 300 milligrams of caffeine per can, making it one of the strongest on the market, the equivalent of 5 espresso shots. Caution, folks, these drinks are not for the faint of heart. Let's not forget, the dose makes the poison. Caffeine is a widely consumed stimulant that can have both positive and negative effects on the body and brain.